Yeah, that was just an accident. It's really bad. It's really bad.
Are you okay?
I wasn't in an accident. I just saw it. This is all my friends. And then,
this is breaking news from Channel 8 Eyewitness News.
Good morning, I'm Dave Crevassier with some breaking news right now. Eyewitness News is on the scene of a pretty serious car crash. Police say the crash has tragically taken the life of a local teen and has seriously injured several others. An Eyewitness News crew happened to be in the area and arrived on the scene prior to emergency personnel to give us this unprecedented look at a tragic crash.
Yeah, I think I hit my head.
Me too. Call some, get some help.
I think so.
Get some help. Some help. Some help. I'm scared.
Roll medical, got a possible 419.
Assigned to
Tom 695,
please.
All right, expedite medical. I've got a subject over here. Smells of alcohol. I got alcohol bottles in the back of the vehicle, all over the dash. I got one that's no pulse over here.
All right, I'll take the DUI.
Dispatch engine 28 arrived at 10,000. Home stretch, we have a two vehicle NVA double ejection. Looks like we have at least four injuries. Start a second rescue and two additional Medic West units.
Smells of alcohol, we got beer bottles here.
Hey, how you doing, man?
You all right? Yeah, what happened? Right. Where were you coming from? A friend's house? Okay. I smelled a little bit of alcohol. Have you had anything to drink today? A little bit? A little bit? Okay. All right. Well, I'm a little concerned for you.
Can you do me a favor? Go ahead and step out of the car, please.
Okay. Come on out. Some injuries on you? No, just your nose right there? Okay. Come on, step over here for me, okay? Let's get out of this mess.
What's your first name?
Huh?
Jackson.
We've got a critical in this truck.
Got it.
And a critical on the hood. She's gonna go first.
Okay. Well, right now she seems pretty stable. She's got an airway. She's able to say her name.
Okay.
She's in C-spine. If we can get her extricated to a gurney, then I can help and...
Okay. One 419 Metro's got the LZ blocked to the east at Hualapai at Homestead, and we have it blocked.
Tell me your name.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're gonna get you out of here soon. Okay.
What were you drinking earlier today? Ben, stay here. Stay here, buddy. Just a little bit of beer.
Dispatch from command. Go ahead and launch Mercy Air.
Jackson, I'm a little bit concerned about your ability to drive right now, okay? So what I'd like to do is I'd like to do just a real standard field sobriety test. Hey, focus on me. Can you see the tip of my finger right here, bud? You see that? Okay, I just want you to follow the tip of my finger with your eyes and your eyes only, okay? Keep your head still. Do you understand? Do you understand? Okay, here we go. You ready? Just follow my finger. Keep your head still. Keep your head still. I want you to keep following my finger, okay? Keep following, keep following, keep following, keep following. Okay, do me a favor, close your eyes for me.
Engine 28 copies, I can hear you coming in.
Okay.
Engine 28 has visual.
As soon as that shuts down, we'll bring her on out.
Okay.
Thanks, Tony.
I want you to pretend that there's a line, imaginary line between you and me, okay? And between this imaginary line right here, stay focused on me. Between this imaginary line right here, I want you to put your left foot on the line like this. Can you do that for me? Okay, I want you to place your right foot in front of your left with the heel of your right foot touching the toe of your left. Go ahead and do that. I'm gonna demonstrate that for you, okay? Keeping your hands down at your side and looking at your feet, you're gonna count. Your first step is one, so it's gonna look like this. One, two, three. I've done three, you're gonna do nine. Hey, hey, focus on me. Okay, whenever you're ready, I want you to begin, okay? Count your first step is one, looking down at your feet. Awesome, okay. The next test I want you to try and do, okay, stay with me. Stay with me. I want you to put your feet together like this. I want you to put your hands down at your side. Okay? I want you to stay in this position until I tell you to begin. From this position, you're gonna raise one of your legs, one of your feet off the ground, 6 inches off the ground. I don't care which one, it's your choice. Okay, you're gonna point your toe, and while looking down at your toe with your foot off the ground, you're gonna count out loud. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004. You understand so far?
1011.
Okay. You haven't had any drugs today, right? Okay. Just a little bit of alcohol? Okay. All right. You is Jackson, right? Okay. Jackson, at this particular point in time, you under arrest for DUI. I'm going to have you go with this gentleman here, okay, and I'll meet you down in the county. All right. Fantastic.
What do we have today?
Okay, we have two vehicles. The Ford was initially going eastbound in T1. Your GMC pickup truck is going westbound when he crosses over the center line into eastbound T1. The head-on causes both vehicles to rotate. The impact from the head-on caused, we believe, the driver from the Ford to be ejected. And this is where he lands.
Oh. Okay.
He's been pronounced dead on scene.
Anyone else in that vehicle?
Yeah. She was life-flighted. She was critical. We got two others in the GMC. The driver, we suspect he's DUI, but his passenger had serious injuries. She's on her way to UMC Mercy Ground. We do have them identified in the pickup truck.
Okay.
They are both students of Faith Lutheran right here. We haven't suspected anything as far as alcohol or impairment on the
in
Ford.
This vehicle.
Right. But it did catch fire. FD came and put it out.
Okay. We even have a Bible with
you. Yeah.
Very tragic scene there. The injured teens were transported to UMC Trauma Center. Channel 8 Eyewitness News had a crew there when they arrived and updating us now on their conditions.
Got CPR in progress. She's starting to code in flight. belts off.
One, two, three. All right, go ahead and take over, Baggy.
Yeah. Got it.
Big bump.
Dex, I don't think they got the word on that. We didn't have time to call.
17-year-old female, she was the unrestrained passenger in a vehicle, partially ejected. Took them about 15 minutes to extricate her from the rest of her body from the vehicle.
One, two, three.
It's been about, since she went to arrest, about 3 minutes.
3 minutes? Let's get her up on the monitor. You guys had a PEA arrest?
PEA of about 120. Sinus.
Okay.
Let's get two large 4 IVs.
Needle decompression going in.
Okay.
Approximately 30 seconds ago.
Be continue compressions.
All right. Another epi.
Push TV on push the ultrasound.
Don't feel a pulse.
All right. We're going to go ahead and call it. Time of death. 11:57.
Stace, time of death, 11:57.
Did you get any family notifications?
Hi there. Are you Maddie's parents?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Dr. Preddy. Were you guys there today? Did you guys hear what happened? Were you at the scene?
Yeah, we saw it.
I'm very sorry for what happened to her. She, when she got here, when the helicopter landed, they lost her vital signs. And we were unable to get her vital signs back. We gave her a lot of drugs. We did some procedures on her to try to get her heart to restart. But unfortunately, we could not get her heart restarted. And she passed away. I'm so sorry. Now, she's a coroner's case. So we're not allowed to remove any of the things we did. But if you would like to see her before the coroner takes her, I think that would be okay.
Please.
Are you prepared for that? Are you sure you're ready for that? Okay, she's a little bit bloody.
Pretty well. She's still stable. I have pulses on her. Hey, Miss Ophelia, still with me?
Mm-hmm.
It's gonna be bright out here.
Mm-hmm. Couple bumps.
Little bumps. Here we go. Name is Ohima Dixon, 16 years old, motor vehicle accident. She is still alert and conscious, knows her name, writing the time and date. Last vitals, still stable, 137.7, pulse of 95. Unknown as to whether there is an injury.
Is she a restrained driver, passenger?
Restrained passenger. Heads up.
Hands on your chest, yep.
Watch your hands. There you go.
Passenger compartment intrusion?
No. The car that hit her had the most damage.
Okay.
And what hurts?
Your head?
Oh, okay.
That's where you're cut? Does anything else hurt? Okay. Big breath for me. And out. This wrist hurt? Elbow? Shoulder? Bend your knee. Does any of that hurt? Okay. What about this one? Does any of that hurt? Not really? Okay. Let's get her covered up. We can get a blanket. Okay. Do you remember the accident?
A little bit.
Okay. We got a big cut on your face. We're going to have to call on the plastic surgeons, have them get that sewn up right, okay? Keep your pretty face. Are you breathing okay? Okay. One, two, three. Good. Did your back hurt when I touch? Okay, and down. One, two, three. Good. All right, we're gonna get some x-rays, get a scan of your face and your head, and then we're gonna get probably have to get you some stitches, okay?
Certainly a parent's worst nightmare and another young life taken as a result of this horrible crash. As you saw, police arrested one of the teen drivers for DWI. Channel 8 Eyewitness News is at the Clark County Detention Center for that part of the story.
All right, go straight back, all the way back.
Metro, 56, put me in there.
That's
right.
Oh,
it's still right there.
Is that blood on your nose anywhere else?
No.
I thought your arms spray feet all over me.
We're gonna do a blood draw.
Okay. Go and sit down right now. Take out your shoes and socks. Then have it. Okay. Is that blood?
Right. No.
Come this way, man.
There.
Come up here. They got those pants with this one on. Trauma.
Right.
Come on, take a seat.
So don't move. If you need to tighten your body, you can tighten all your body, but leave this arm relaxed, okay? Ready. One, two, three.
Turn face me. Look at that camera lens. It's above the, my head, center light. Turn to the right. I need your side profile.
All right, sir, come on, step over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take your fingerprints. I'm going to start with your left hand, and we're going to move to your right hand.
Good afternoon. This case is State of Nevada versus Jackson Langford. We're here for the sentencing with regard to a DUI death case. State, did you have something you wanted to say before we proceed to the sentencing?
Yes, thank you, Your Honor. One and done should be the rule. One drink, no driving. Defendant broke two laws. Though not old enough, he drank. Though drinking, he drove. It's a tragedy for everyone. While he's ruined his own life, he's taken the lives of his friends. How horrible for his parents for the next however many years to visit him up at the prison. But more heartbreaking for the other families and friends who will visit their children in the cemetery. For taking a ride with the defendant, Hunter and Madison paid the maximum price. For that, justice demands the maximum penalty.
Thank you. Counsel?
Your Honor, I just ask you to note that my client is a very young man. This is the one and only crime he has ever committed, and he is certainly very, very sorry for what has occurred. This was a tragic accident.
Mr. Langford, do you have anything to say?
If I could take it back, I would.
Is that it? Okay. I usually start a little differently, but I appreciate, counsel, that you referred to it as a crime, because that's exactly what it is. Oftentimes I hear that this is just a tragic accident, and it's not. You chose to drink. You chose to get behind the wheel of a car. You chose to place your friends in that car with you. And you chose to end their lives. This was not an accident. This was a deliberate act that you chose to do that is a crime. Unfortunately, we see on a regular basis the devastation caused by drunk driving accidents, the deaths, the lives ruined, the families torn apart, the communities torn apart. I hate to say that a life has been ruined, but in these particular cases, they truly have. There is no loss greater than the loss of a child for a parent. And for these parents to have to live every day for the rest of their lives wondering what their child would have become, who they would have married, if they would have had children, is absolutely devastating and unacceptable. The good news for your parents is that they will get to see you. They will get to see you grow older. But unfortunately, they are every bit as devastated as the parents of these children who are dead, because they're good people, and not only do they mourn for you, but they mourn for these families that have lost their children, and who, as Ms. Holthus says, will only be able to visit their children in a cemetery from this day forward. So let's not forget that this is not an accident. This is a crime. This was intentional. And for the lives that you have devastated, for the lives that you have ended, you deserve the maximum penalty. And so on each of the three counts, you will be sentenced to 20 years in the Nevada Department of Prisons, each of those sentences running consecutively. Thank you.
Another young life ruined by making the bad decision to drink and drive. We go now to the Clark County Coroner's Office to find out more about the teen who was pronounced dead at the scene.
One of the Faith Lutheran students, and sounds like we've got a mom that will be coming down here to see if this is his son. So if you can, let's try and cover him up the best we can of some of the injuries.
Jordan, Eric, thank you so much for coming. We had several kids involved in this. We were told this might be Hunter. Is this Hunter? Yeah. And who is your son? He's been hit on by a fellow student that was already arriving at school from this morning. From what we know of your son, it's just an incident between them, tossed over and struck your son. There was another friend in the vehicle with him that was taken over the UMC. I don't know their condition just yet, or if their family has been
So you can see just how many people are affected by this tragic crash. Driving while impaired is no accident, it is no mistake, it is a crime, and it kills people. Eyewitness News will have more updates on this horrible crash throughout the day.
Can't get used to this.
family that's lost a family member. We have friends that have lost their friend. We have boyfriends and girlfriends, they're gone. Brothers and sisters, they're gone. They're dead. Dead is dead. You don't come back. It's not a video game. And when you're dead, you're dead. And for us that work here, we're very passionate about it, simply for the reason that we know that the majority of these could be prevented.
It's a lot harder than you would think it is going through that whole process, and I didn't even go through the actual process, I was just acting, but it's scary, so just think.
Time will heal long wounds, and the pain will eventually fade. You've always been the light of my life, and that light will never fade away.
I don't think kids think anybody my age was ever their age. You know, and I understand that. I didn't think that when I was 16, 17, 18, I didn't think anybody was ever my age, okay? But we all were. You know, I lucked out, I made it, and I want to see that they luck out. And it's not luck, it's planning, it's doing the right thing, it's not doing the wrong thing and getting behind that wheel. You know, that's thousands of pounds of metal that's in there. It's a deadly weapon, and that's what people don't get. It's no different than a gun, and it demands the same respect as you would if you had a gun in your hand. When you're behind the wheel of that car, it's a deadly weapon, and if you don't do the right thing, you can die, your passengers can die, or you can cause someone else to die.